Good day! Welcome to another episode of Path of Exile, The Awakening. At least my let's play of it with the Hardcore Ranger. Last time we defeated a bunch of bandits. This time I'm continuing in the, what's it called, the Western Forest. Because besides the witch that we befriended for a mana, there's also a bunch of black cards here that are blocking the way. And I believe that there's a reward for taking out the black cards. And I like rewards. So, here I am, bow for hire. On my way to get more rewards. Also a nice thing that I picked up as a quest reward is a physical projectile attack damage, which adds 30% extra physical projectile attack in exchange for 10% slower attacks. And it's now attached to the poison arrow, which actually doesn't convert the damage itself. It just adds physical damage on top as chaos damage. So this one gets maximum effect because there's 30% more damage that then also gets converted into chaos. So it's a win-win. So this attack now does close to 200 points of physical damage per second. But for clearing groups, there's nothing that quite beats the ice arrow. It's just so good. But the damage increase there felt not as impressive.
Artiri, my beautiful captain. I wish it were not you, but I cannot bring myself to trust any other with this most vital of tasks. This is the only pass between the Inner and Outer Empire. No further exiles are to enter the Inner Empire. We have material enough for our work. Ensure that the barricade remains in place, and if any exile should somehow pass through, kill them. I will send for you when my work is complete in San. Until we share our next night together. Piety.
I don't remember this one being there. Well, it's interesting seeing that there's a bit more background. So Piety and the captain, whoever the captain is, had a thing. Or she's using him. It's also rather possible. Thaumaturgic emblem. Also, captain is no more. Talk to Bestol. And it's funny, we can walk back to Act 1 now. Which is a level 10 area. I believe there was a waypoint here, wasn't there? Yeah. Probably should port to town, but killing low level mobs is kind of funny as well. Waypoint. Hey, Flame Hellion. Burning Menace. Superior items, superior item. And we found a waypoint, sweet. Bestol, hello.
Hey.
And we get a passive skill point. I approve. Oh yes. This was a bunch of extra survivability. There was damage here. Actually, I was kind of going for a evasion build. So let's build this one up. We have one extra percent chance to dodge. Or to evade, not to be confused with dodge, which is a different thing. Okay, so for Act 2, there's now two quests left. Intruders in Black, so that's the Chamber of Sin, if I remember correctly. And Pushing Onwards to the Top, so let's go and do that first and then jump to the crossroads. Which is this way. Haha, miss me. Jonah Unchained. Nothing else that sticks out. Let's see, cat's paw, plated gauntlets. Oh, and we boosted lightning damage. This has a bunch of bonus damage. I'm always a big fan of things with bonus damage. This is quite some damage indeed. Lose a bit of life leech, but we gain life regen instead. Fire resist shifts to cold resist, which is actually a good thing. Yeah. Let's go for it. Oh wait, we have the blue thing, the lightning. Alright. Just put it in a nice corner, keep it for later. Why did I pick that one up? Okay, let's push on. Chamber of Sin, here we come. Wow, level already? That was quick. Ew, stay dead. Extra life. Up until this point,
let us speak of death.
I haven't changed a lot to the areas. This not that I can tell. It's been a while. I mean, the masters are new, but Act 2 is still pretty much Act 2. They did some rebalancing with item levels, since most of my gear now already has 3 sockets. I think that didn't happen until Act 3 before, and now you already get them from the start, so that's good. I think potion levels have changed a little bit from what's changed on the wiki, what's listed on the wiki. They're available slightly earlier. We'll take mummies. Okay, please don't attack me. Gross. Oh no, we get respawning skeletons. Okay, I got green pits. Let's go back to Katarina and hand them in. Here you go. Yes. Thank you. Level 2. Okay, but that was just a speed bump. Let's push on to the west. But as I said, there's small details that are different, but the big picture is still the same. There's a lot of lore now that didn't. It used to be there. You know, like the.
Luxury and cruelty go hand in hand.
The letter from Piety to the captain, things like that. I don't remember seeing it before. Those are nice touches. It all just adds to the look and feel and depth of the world. Which is nice. Oh, Black Death. Ooh, yes, got you bleeding now. Okay, man. And that spider. I mean, The inevitable comparison with the Diablo franchise always comes up in games like Path of Exile. And I'd say Path of Exile is a very worthy successor to Diablo 2. Ancient Reverie device. Ah, no voice acting yet. Transmog, Virtual Gem, bloody bloody, bloody bloody, bloody bloody. Okay. Some background lore. Okay, I was talking. Yeah, Diablo. It's a very worthy successor to Diablo 2. Diablo 3 went a totally different route. Still, you know, it's highly entertaining. It's got the name, it's got the world, it's got the setting. But Diablo 2, especially when played on hardcore mode, it was a pretty brutal game. It relied a lot on player skill and just making choices about where to assign skill points and how you played your character and what skills you picked. You had a skill tree, you had points to spend, and you had attributes that you could assign. And you could literally play a character without any equipment on, so-called nude characters, and, you know, beat the game with it. Diablo 3, it's a totally different game. You can't do that. You're totally gear dependent. And yeah, that's just, it's picked up a lot of influence from the World of Warcraft of the world, where item progression is more important than actual character progression. And you know, for us people that really played a lot of Diablo, heck, Diablo 2 is from 2001, if I remember correctly. Or the Lord of Destruction expansion is from 2001. Either way, it's 14 years old. I played it until about a year before Diablo 3 was launched. I played it for over 10 years. Had a group of friends, and we played once or twice a week. And we played hardcore groups, and we had challenge builds, and you know, we made the game more difficult, because the default game, it was pretty cookie cutter. So we had things like paladins with crossbows, and no crafting, and no, everything was self-found, and highly, highly challenging stuff. And then you get Diablo 3, and yeah, it was a bit of a letdown in that regard. It's still entertaining, I played from every time to time, but yeah, it's all about the gear, it's all about the grind, it's not about moving your own personal skill. And to get back to Path of Exile, it resembles Diablo 2 more than it resembles Diablo 3, and that's a good thing. I really like the skill system, the big web of passives. It's really nice. Skill gems in your gear also allow you to do crazy things. The fact that character classes are only starting points instead of totally defining for who you are. Okay, they help define your quest rewards. That's the only big difference. Whoa! Ah, big ghost. Yeah, big ghost, and it disappears after a while, and we killed it. Sweet. And we got a clarity
gem. That would only slow me down.
Ah, that's the mana aura. It reserves some mana, and then you gain extra regen. Okay, that's pretty sweet, actually. Go from 4.8 to something a bit more. Let's see, puncture. Let's just stick it in here. re-roll the color on this one a bit later. Okay, I'm gonna go to town. Hold my thoughts.
What?
You buy all the crappy stuff I don't want. Superior Trilink. Superior. Yeah, I wanted to keep this one as well. For now, that's enough. Put all the things in. New flask, useful things. Just put all the. Just quickly put them in. Superior armors. Superior weapon. Oh, that was a. That's a useful item. Get back to crafting. That's just a. Take a couple of these along, that's useful. Ah, I needed more things that were useful. That one in, burning arrow. Where you got that? Let's see, these are arrows. Yep. Okay, let's just jump down again. Pick up the things before the incense disappears. All the things that are interesting picked up. Now let's have a look. Oh yeah, this was going to be a boost, but we needed some color changes. Is that useful? Yeah, one of these rolls blue. Two blue and red. Seriously? One of each. Suppose that works for the lightning arrow setup. So. Yeah, and I had an idea about clarity. So back to town. Hopping up and down. Let's just try to reroll. It's on the boots. No, need to take them off. Yep. Ah, cool. Blue on the first try. Okay. So we can hop. Wait, you don't need that one anyway. Back to the useful items. Why is this mixed up? Superior weapons. You. No. Superior. Don't care about the goat hides. Just want them. It's a trike. Plus one level of socket bow gems. Okay, we have a serious contender for the next big bow. 133. 148, that's a boost. Sweet. Okay, so we have a poison arrow which has triple links. I don't actually have a reforge the link, so well, I'm lucky. Try. Success on the first shot, okay. So, ice arrow. Oh cool, can actually add something to the ice arrow if we have a passive for it. Or just add one of the other ones. Okay, cool, ice shots. Clickety. Lesser multiple projectiles. Yeah, so is there something we want to split? We already got the poison arrow as a single target. Let's do the puncture. Might be useful for taking on bigger groups of enemies. Just to get them bleeding. Quick look, this is useful. Meh. Just add it. Superior small life flask. And then sell this one.
What?
What? We sell it. That's what we do. Okay. Put that in and then back down into the dungeon. Okay. Da-da-da-da-da-da. this is now one level higher due to this, as well as puncture. Cool, so this is 120 DPS, 145 DPS. Cool, we have a staircase. Run around this way. Next level. Waypoint, that's good. Can we get back here? As needed. Let's see if we can finish this dungeon before the end of the episode. Superior. After I'm done recording, I'm gonna clear out all the superior items and get some more crafting materials from that. Strongholds. Clear the area a little bit. You. No hide and seek. Okay. Can we boost it? Yes, we still have it. Freeze me when activated. And items have a 6% quality. That's pretty sweet. Okay. Freeze. Quality. So there's a lot of items that are just lower grade but 6% quality. Oh, composite bow. Yeah, not good enough. Let's keep it and sell it. Can do that. Before I got distracted by all the shinies, I was rambling about this comparison between Path of Exile and Diablo. Might have slightly lost my train of thought there. Oh yeah, skill system. I was happy about that. The gems, passives. And now also with the jewels. I'm curious to see what that's going to do. I still have yet to find a jewel to socket into the passives. Let's see, that is cleared. Let's go the way. But my only complaint about Path of Exile from the past is a similar complaint as I also have about Torchlight 2, and that's just that the difficulty curve is, well, there's no real difficulty curve, there's just occasional, there's a lull where you get, you know, you get a false sense of security, by the way, and you just blitz through the content, and then suddenly there's a boss or an act boss that's just on just another level, and you more or less get insta wiped. Or here with the Dominus fight at the end of Act 3. You have to follow the choreographed dance, more or less, or you get killed. Which feels not satisfying. If you're doing good at the game itself, and then you die because you didn't stand outside of the insta-kill zone for the boss fight. That's not happy about that. Transmutia device. A baleful gem. Talk to Helena. That's the woman here.
To damnation with piety. She was after one of Meligaro's creations, the baleful gem.
Also, Meligaro.
You have it. Good. It's something that wicked woman must never get her hands on. You've seen the encampment on top of the dam.
Okay, so she's a deserter, basically, from the Ebony Legion. Ghost!
The Oriasen girl.
She's alive. Cool, let me get a reward. Herald of Ice. It's Channel ice through your hands, adding cold damage to spells and attacks. If you shatter an enemy, they explode. That's pretty cool. Damage cannot be reflected. Herald of Thunder. Herald of Ash. A frenzy. Kind of sticks out like a sore thumb. But yeah. Let's see, this I'm a Dex character, so then Herald of Ice makes a lot of sense. But this is a mana reserve, so this is like an aura, personal aura. Okay. I'll have a look. Put this in here. And I think I forgot to activate Clarity and the Herald of Ice. Silly me. Helena, hello.
Here I stand in the light of the tree that Gina calls the spirit is strong.
Katarina.
The dead have taken.
Ooh, can invite her to the hideout.
We'll make an artist out of you yet.
And then we got her. Oh wait, shouldn't I do that with Tora?
Ready for the hunt?
Actually, you have to yet encounter in the wild again. Okay, so that one is solved. Chamber of Sin. So now we got a crypt on that side, and we have a continuation of the quest with Malagaro's spike and the Baleful Gem. Oh, it's time, so I'm gonna call this episode, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.